Buonasera, good evening. Thank you to the American Chamber of Commerce Italy for the invitation. I so looked forward to joining you this evening in person. But Secretary of State Pompeo has called me back to Washington to join him for an important diplomatic meeting Tuesday morning. I'm so very sorry to miss these festivities, recalling our work together when I served as Consul General in Milan. It is still a deep honor to speak to you at this 14th Annual Transatlantic Award Gala, in my current capacity, leading the Department of State's Bureau of European and Eurasian Affairs. As Ambassador Eisenberg, Consul General Martinez, and Italian Ambassador Verricchio will attest, the strong relations between the United States and Italy would not be possible without organizations like AmCham, which foster our partnership and work hard every day to deepen economic ties. I am grateful to AmCham Italy, to my friend Simone Crolla and his team, for your tireless advocacy on behalf of businesses that allows our economic cooperation to flourish. The robust ties between our two countries benefit our businesses, our workers, and our transatlantic community. There's no doubt in my mind, when we remove barriers to trade, when we open markets, and when we understand how to invest in each other's country, businesses flourish and our economies prosper. That is good for the United States, and that is good for Italy. Just 2 months ago, President Trump welcomed President Mattarella to Washington. Right before that, Secretary Pompeo traveled to Italy, where he met with Italian leaders and visited his ancestral home in Abruzzo. As President Trump said, the bonds between Italy and the United States have never been more solid. I thank AmCham and all of you for helping foster ties between our two countries. I know that tonight, Milano is still the place to be, and I'm sorry I cannot be there with you, but I'm with you in spirit, with thanks, with friendship. Buon proseguimento e grazie mille.